Next question is from Kairos Captures. Are alkaline and pH water another processed item on the market, or are they worth the money?
Here's a great example of taking, you know, maybe some applications of alkaline water and saying there may be some benefit, and then just, you know, doing it across the board.
Yeah, bastardizing it.
Which is, yeah. So, okay, so alkaline.
$5 bottle of water now.
Right, so yeah. Water has, I think normal water's pH levels like 8 or 8.5 or something like that, and something that's alkaline is over that, and oftentimes the way that they improve its the alkaline quality of water is by adding certain buffering minerals to the water. So now, you know, water is a little bit more alkaline, meaning it will counteract some acidity in the body. What are the potential applications? Well, I guess if you have acid reflux issues, maybe it might help a little bit, in which case I'd say eat a Tums or a Rolaids, which is way more alkaline. It'll solve that issue a little bit better.
Or just eat, you know, like non-inflammatory foods.
Yeah. Now, is it going to change the alkaline of the measurements of your body? Probably not. Your body maintains its pH balance pretty damn good.
That's how I thought they dispelled this, right? I thought they did, because that's how the true way to test if this works is to drink this stuff and then like take a piss test, right? Isn't that how they would measure and like see if it's actually changing it?
Yeah, your body is very, very good at maintaining a certain pH level, because if it goes a little bit outside of that, even if it goes too alkaline or too acidic, it's not good.
Bad.
It can become quite dangerous. What you might get is a little bit more alkaline in your gut. Just like, you know, eating a calcium or magnesium product like Tums or Rolaids. Otherwise,
well,
just regular spring water.
Like, isn't it too, like most people that, and I know in my case specifically, like I'm not producing acid when I should be producing acid. And so that's really the biggest problem that I've been facing. And so it'll show up, at night or inopportune times where I'm needing to digest food. And it's training that to, you know, my body to really get that response while I'm eating the food.
Yeah, and I mean, here's the other side of it, right? If you drink water that is devoid of minerals and it's all you drink, you could cause electrolyte imbalance.
Like distilled?
Yeah, distilled would be the worst, right? If you just drink distilled water, you could cause problems,
right?
Because you're flushing out or causing imbalances with electrolytes. So just regular mineralized spring water, tap water, believe it or not, is fine. pH water, you're spending more money for something that does nothing for you. And what if you're not producing enough acid and you throw more alkaline? You can actually make the problem.
Well, yeah, I guess that's what I was getting at.
Yeah, you can make the problem even worse. And this is what marketers do. They'll take something that everybody knows they need more of, like water, and they'll say, how can we inexpensive, you know, in a very inexpensive way, make it seem more valuable to buy our water. So they'll say our water's pH balance is higher. What'd they do? They added a little bit of, you know, magnesium to it or something.
Isn't
like
it
that
interesting to you guys? Like, I want Doug. Do you have any idea? You're old. Do you have this? You probably have a better idea of this.
Do you remember when water?
Was
invented.
No, I mean, I remember as a kid. We drank from the garden hose for at least a quarter of my life, I would say. So they didn't. There wasn't even
Then it was just hydrogen oxygen.
Bottled water wasn't even a thing. Like you didn't go buy bottled water anywhere. Like that wasn't a thing. That was like, if you did, you were like storing for like.
You were like rich. Only rich people bought like.
Not even that. It was like, because you're going camping or somewhere and you wouldn't be able to get to water. Maybe you bought but other than that, nobody bought water bottles. Like, right, Doug? Yeah. It was like, you just drink.
No, just drink out of the tap,
out of hose, right?
Right?
Yeah.
And so this has to be like a multi-billion-dollar industry now that like didn't even exist like 20 years ago.
Oh, at the time, I can remember when it first came on the market and I go, why would I pay for water? This is ridiculous.
Yes, yeah. Right?
We gotta start bottling up air.
Bro, Spaceballs. Remember in Spaceballs?
Yes, I know.
You're gonna buy a can of air?
Yeah.
Remember that?
Oh, I did.
Yeah,
that's
buy
right.
A can of air. I think that's brilliant. That's totally like the next move.
I think you guys are onto something.
Yeah, no, it's funny too is that bottled water is one of the largest contributors to waste because of all the plastic bottles. So people are like, this is good, you know, it's healthy, whatever. You've got all these plastic bottles that we're dumping into.
You know, those islands of plastic.
Yeah, it's there's no huge benefit. Just regular water is fine. Tap water is usually fine. If you feel like you need to clean it further, buy yourself a purifier so you're not, you know, wasting a bunch of plastic bottles. But pH water is largely a total gimmick.
If you're a real gangster, you'll drink out of the garden hose.
Yeah.